is, you were telling me earlier that this wasn't just, I mean, they have a lot of staff there.
Yes.
I mean, you used to work at JP Morgan Chase. You know, it's not like there's only one person at JP with a code. Now, granted, that's a little different than a crypto exchange,
mm-hmm.
but there's gotta be somebody else other than one person, one dude,
exactly.
with the password, right? I mean, it would just be malfeasance, it would seem like.
Exactly, and it's highly unlikely that there's absolutely no business continuity plan in place. And this extends even further from like cryptocurrency and technology, like even any multinational consumer product corporation, they have business continuity plans in place. In fact, execs aren't even allowed to fly on the same plane as each other for fear something might happen to a plane. Businesses have this rule in place in order to protect investors and to protect stockholders and shareholders. So it goes to say that if you're a custodian of $190 million worth of cryptocurrency, that you have some sort of plan in place, whether it's in your will or legally established otherwise.
You enlightened me, the former regulator, on something we were talking about. I think it's odd that a 30-year-old would have a will, but you said, well, you know, it could be required
mm-hmm.
In some places because of, as you say, that we used to call it in government, continuity of operations program, COOP, so that they might have to have one of these things, but a will. But you're telling me the will is not that old, right?
The will was actually only established a month ago before his death in November. Again, the timing of everything makes it very highly suspicious. And so that's why a lot of people suspect foul play out here.
What a really bizarre story. We appreciate you talking with us about it. I wanted to ask you before we leave, we talked last week about the Iranian effort to establish a crypto backed by gold. Now, what do you make of this, Christy?
So this actually recently launched. It's called Paymon, and currently it's backed by four banks out of Iran in order to circumvent the U.S. sanctions that have wreaked havoc on their economy as a whole. So right now they're trying to use Paymon to establish a cryptocurrency trade agreement with other commercial corporations in order to further boost their economy and trade agreements with Europe. But I do suspect that they will have a hard time with investors and as well as end users within Europe trying to establish big, large commercial transactions using cryptocurrency.
It didn't work out so well for the petro in Venezuela. I mean, it seemed with Venezuela sort of like a last-ditch effort. That sort of seems like it here. Can I get your take? We've just got a little bit of time, 45 seconds or so. What's your take on where Bitcoin's going this year and what needs to be done?
I think right now we are on the verge. We talked a lot about the SEC and the likely approval of a Bitcoin ETF, and I think that that's something that is again on the table here and is going to be something that's going to be talked again this first quarter this year.
Well, we'll look forward to it, and I hope you'll come back to talk about it with us. Christy, I have counter.
So I do want to talk about this Bitcoin ETF and the SEC approval. It has not emerged yet, and I think this is the catalyst that we're hoping for. Some analysts are saying that the crypto winter will last for another year or two, but I do believe that there is going to be an opportunity for some sort of growth, especially if there's instability in the markets. So I will be paying attention and trying to cover that aspect of it. And on the previous information, just be very careful when you're investing in cryptocurrencies. Do not have all your money on one exchange. Diversification is key for any kind of investment, so do not put all your eggs in one basket. But let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you guys soon.